Welcome everyone in today's session. Today we have gone through a lot of amazing parts. We had one sentence narrative, first of all. Then we have dialogue practice, the real life situation. And then we have some unplanned dialogue practices, where you have to create your own sentences. Today I'd like to introduce some verbs here, as you have seen that it is written already. Blandish, it means to flatter. Accord is another word. Accord means agree or some sort of symphony. Alleviate, it means to remove or to solve something. Amass means to collect. Annex means to connect. Appal means some sort of dangerous situation to create. Backbite means to criticize somebody. Buck, this is another very important word. Bata, barrack. Barrack refers to kind of cantonment area. Bass, bacon, beguile, fox, browbeat, then capitulate, choke. So all these verbs, I have just narrated 50% of it. Rest of the 50%, you have to tell me, because I have done something for you, then you do the rest. That will be so helpful. We will learn some new words, because most often we learn swim, write, take, carry, help. These verbs are very commonly used, but if you know some new verbs, I'm sure that will be very helpful for you. I didn't tell all the meanings of all the verbs. I told you some of the verbs' meaning. And I can tell you choke. Choke means to become breathless, choke to death, to unable to breathe properly. It's called choke. So, and browbeat. I can give you some idea. Browbeat means to dominate someone with a threat, some sort of situation like that. So other words are very interesting. I believe that if you close a bit, please look at the words once again. I'm reading, I'm not telling you the meaning. Blandish, accord, alleviate, amass, annex, appel, backbite, balk, butter, barrack, bass, beckon, beguile, coax, browbeat, capitulate, choke. So I believe that if you know the words well, your English will be very powerful. That's it from here. Thank you very much, and please complete the task properly.
Learning English language is the gateway to be a modern citizen of the world. We must acquire it.
English is an invisible weapon for the modern world.
Hello everyone. English is not only a power of women, but also a strength to survive in this society.
Hello guys, English has a marvelous and indomitable strength if it is accessed all skilled together.
English is a medium of communication, but if it is English language, it is more than that.
Hello guys, full operational command over all skills of English language means you are global citizen.
Hello everyone. Developing linguistic competence in English and making communicative competence successful will certainly lead us to a very glorious state.
English as a second language gives us both irresistible power and unlimited confidence.
English is a very powerful language to be fit in the global arena. Learning a language, if it is English, is certainly have taught to fight a lot of difficulties in the world.
Hello everyone. A foreign language like English is certainly a great mechanism to deal with the international links.
Hello everyone. English is the global demand for the job sector right now. Thank you.
Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes, I do. What can I do for you?
I would like to post this annual letter to London.
That's 12 chapters, please. Anything else?
Yes, I would like stamps for 6 letters to England.
Here you are. That's 84 altogether.
84 taka?
Yes, 12 for this letter and 72 for 6 stamps. That makes 84. What can I do for you?
I want to post this letter.
Do you want to post by... Okay, what else do you want?
Can I also send parcel?
Yes, you can. But where is this? This sentence can't be right.
Let me check. Oh yes, it's wrong.
Let me correct it correctly.
I don't have the address with me now.
Then I am afraid that you can't send it right now.
Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes, I do. What can I do for you?
I would like to post this letter and the letter to London.
That's 12 o'clock, please. Anything else?
Yes, I would like stamps for 6 letters to England.
Yeah, you are. That's 84 taka. All together.
84 taka?
Yes. 12 taka for later and 72 taka for for 72 taka for stamps. That's 84 taka. What can I do for you?
I want to post this letter.
You want to post this letter by email?
Yes, please.
What else do you want?
I can also sell first.
Yes, you can. But what's this? This address can't be right.
Let me check. Oh, yes, it's wrong.
Let me write it now. Correctly.
I don't have this address in me now.
Then I'm afraid. You can't post it now.
Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes, I do. What can I do for you?
I'd like to post this airmail letter to London.
That's 12 taka, please. Anything else?
Yes, stamps for 6 letters to England.
Here you are. That's 84 taka.
84 taka?
Yes. Yes, 12 taka for the letter and 72 for 6 stamp. That makes 84. What can I do for you?
I want to post this letter.
Do you want to post this letter by email?
Yes, please.
What else do you want?
Can I say it first, sir?
Yes, you can. But what is this? This address cannot be right.
Let me check. Oh, yes, it's wrong.
Let me write it correctly.
I don't have the address with me now.
Then I am afraid you cannot send it now.
Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes, I do. What can I do for you?
I'd like to post this airmail letter to London.
That's got paper. Is anything else?
Yes, I'd like to stamp for 6 letters to England.
Yeah, you are. That's 84 taka altogether.
84 taka?
Yes, 4 taka for the letter and 72 for 6 stamps. That's me. What can I do for you?
I want to post this letter.
Do you want to post this by email?
Yes, please.
What else do you want?
Can I also send parcel?
Yes, you can. But what's this? This address can be right.
Let me check. Oh yes,
it's
wrong.
Let me write it correctly.
I don't have the address with me now.
Then I'm afraid you can send it now.
Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes, I do. What can I do for you?
I'd like to post this email letter to London.
That's 12 taka, please. Anything else?
Yes, I'd like to send for 6 letters to England.
Here you are. That's 84 taka altogether.
84 taka?
Yes. 12 taka for this letter and 72 for 6 stamps. That make 84 taka. What can I do for you?
I want to post this letter.
Do you want to post this letter by email?
Yes, please.
What email? What else do you want?
Can I also send person?
Yes, you can, but what address can be right?
Let me check. Oh yes, it's wrong.
Let me write this correctly.
I don't have the address with me now.
Then I'm afraid you can't send it now.
Excuse me, do you speak English?
Yes, I do. What can I do for you?
I'd like to post this airmail letter to London.
That's 12 taka. Please, anything else?
Yes, I would like a stamp for 6 letters to England.
Here you are. That's 84 taka altogether.
84 taka?
Yes, 12 taka for the letter and 72 for 6 stamp. That makes 84. What can I do for you?
I want to post this letter.
Do you want to post by email?
Yes, please.
What else do you want?
Can I also send person?
Yes, you can. But what's this? This address can't be right.
Let me check. Oh yes, it's wrong.
Let me write it, Kathleen.
I don't have the address with me now.
Then I am afraid you can't send it.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
How are you?
Yeah, how about you?
I'm fine.
Alright, you applied for site manager post, right, in our organization. So I can see from your qualification that you have done your honors and masters in management from Chittagong University, right? So how many members do you have in your family?
Six members.
You have six members. So do you support your family financially?
Yes.
So I can see from your CV that you have a job experience. You have worked in IOM as site manager. So why did you leave that job?
After some time, this project is closed. Then I left this job.
So due to the closure of the project, you left the job?
Yes.
So what is your job experience there? How did you enjoy the work?
It was very much. Sometimes I can gather information and after managing, then I hand over managing director.
Yeah, as your experience and qualification, actually we are trying to think about you and we will let you know tomorrow. Thank you. You are almost selected. Let us try some other candidates.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. What's about you?
Yeah, I'm also fine. You look quite confident.
Yes.
So you are not nervous. That is really positive. So how many members do you have in your family?
Four members.
Great. So you have done your graduation from Eastern University. And I can also see that you have a job experience as site manager post in Doctor Without Borders. So you have a medical experience too. So can you explain what were your job responsibilities?
My job responsibilities is handle nurses, managers, some others.
Yeah, great. So did you find any problem in the job?
Actually, no. For my future, for my better future, I did this job and I want to be joining the another
organization.
So
you were dissatisfied with the salary?
Yes.
So what do you expect from our organization?
$50,000.
Only $50,000. We are trying to offer you $80,000, but you are getting $50,000. So it means you are not very skilled. Yeah. What do you say?
No. Actually, not.
All right. According to the SPAR rule provides, we definitely look into the observations, and we have also interviewed another candidate. And I'm giving you some score. We will match the score, and who will get the better score, he'll be selected. Means you are shortlisted already. Right. Thank you very much. Congratulations, you are shortlisted. We will decide, and we will let you know tomorrow.
Hello, may I come, sir?
Yes, of course. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling very much weakness. I have very headache before the same before.
Oh, sorry to know. Are you taking the medicine that I prescribed you? Okay. Keep patience. It's only a week. You need to want, wait more and check the improvement because your problem is so tough and uncommon.
Yes. Thank you, doctor.
Then I'm giving some tests here. Go to the test room and do this, and I'll prescribe a few more medicines after seeing the test result. Now take this paper and to go for the test.
Okay, I will take medicines properly and I will I will come to you and welcome to you for next week.
You are welcome.
Hello, may I come in, sir?
Yes, come in.
Thank you.
How are you feeling now?
Not good, but I'm feeling the headache as before so much.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Did you take all the medicine that I prescribed you?
Yeah, I'm taking medicine properly, but I'm not getting any changed.
Understand. Actually, your problem is not common, and your problem is different, and you need to wait for some while. It is just a week that you have taken some medicine and I prescribed you. So I think you should wait for more and keep patience and your inner side. Okay,
so
be positive.
So what should I do now, right now?
Okay, so please come here. Close your eyes. Okay. May I see your hands, please?
Of course. Okay.
Okay, sit down.
Thank
you. So, I'm giving you more medicine and some taste, okay? You better go to the other rooms for diagnostic tests and let me know the reports, and I will see the report and I will give you some more medicine so that you can get early recovery, okay? So, let me prescribe you some medicine. And some taste for you, okay? So I think you'll be recovered very soon, okay? So now go to the test room and after your diagnostic test, come to me and I will see you, okay? Thank you, sir.
May I come in, ma'am?
Yes, you can.
Oh, hi, Tara. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning, ma'am. I'm fine. How about you?
Yeah, I'm fine. So how is the study going?
Yeah, ma'am. It's going great.
Fine. Are you ready for the examination?
Actually, ma'am, I am not ready yet, but mostly I'm ready. I will complete my revision in 2 weeks. So I have 1 month in my hand. I think I can manage it.
No. So how many subjects are you revising for the upcoming examination?
Physics and math. Other subjects are mostly complete. You know, ma'am, I'm little bit weak in math, so I'm having some trouble with it.
Listen, I've told you many times, if you need an assistant for math, then let me know.
I think you are busy, so that's why I thought I not to disturb you.
No, I'm not busy, I'm free now. So make a list of your problems and bring it to me. I will try to solve it after the class.
Oh, that will be very amazing for me. So I have completed my exam,
okay,
revision with it. Thank you so much, ma'am.
You're welcome, as always, Tara.
Amana, how are you?
Yes, I'm fine. What about you?
I am fine too. So I have traveled Bandarban recently. How was about trip?
Oh, you're right. Actually, I traveled in Bandarban. The trip was amazing. I can't explain how was this trip amazing to me. I'm also very happy that I have been able to see the scenery, the beauty, natural beauty of Bangladesh.
Tell me something about your trip.
Okay, actually, in the trip we have 5 members. How can I explain? Okay, let me explain. The scenery in the trip about the trip was very beautiful and.
What
you know what? The Bangladesh is one of the most beautiful country, and forest state, most beautiful forest state. And also, I have been seeing the jungles and most beautiful scenery and many other things.
Did you like most?
Actually, the whole trip I liked most and. Something, sorry, two or three things I like most is that hilly roads. The first I like most is that hilly roads. These roads are very, very beautiful. I can't explain how much these roads are very beautiful. And but you have to drive carefully. The roads are ups and downs. So you have to drive there carefully because these roads are ups and down and something risky too.
City. Yes, you are right. To save the natural beauty of our country.
What do you say?
Yes, you are right.
Yes, I'm right. You can also see the beauty of scenery, the beauty, natural beauty of Bangladesh. You can also see here's many kinds of trees. And that's it. Okay, thank you.
Hi, how are you? I'm Petty. And what about you?
I am fine too. I have read an article recently about air pollution and I am very worried about the environment. About why, what happened? I read that the air pollution has been the biggest problem in our world. It is day by day going out of control. Only government cannot solve this problem. So we can see solve the problem.
Yeah, yes, you are right. And this why we experience most air pollution in the big industry air gas. Yeah. So I how can we out this pollution?
This pollution always out of in area. Always controlling now.
Thank you, Vidoy.